e-commerce entrepreneurs. I'm Veronica Wasik, founder of Mavency, where we help Shopify sellers and their bookkeepers to set up, organize, and streamline their financial systems, bookkeeping, and integrations. In this video, I will show you how to reconcile e-commerce clearing accounts in QuickBooks Online. A lot of questions about reconciling e-commerce clearing accounts. Let's review what e-commerce clearing accounts are and how to reconcile them in QuickBooks Online. What are e-commerce clearing accounts? E-commerce clearing accounts represent the timing differences between when sales are made and when payments are received from a payment processor. Clearing account balances are like accounts receivable from each payment processor. Let's take a look at the clearing account workflow. When sales are made, the balance in the e-commerce clearing account increases. When a deposit is received from the payment processor, the balance in the e-commerce clearing account decreases. And when payment processor fees are recorded, the balance in the e-commerce clearing account decreases. Let's take a closer look. In this example, we have $500 of net sales from Shopify processed using Affirm as the payment processor. A couple of days later, a $485 deposit is received from Affirm, and the $15 fee is recorded in QuickBooks. The net effect of these transactions in the Affirm clearing account is zero. Let's quickly talk about the QuickBooks Online chart of accounts setup. In order to properly account for and reconcile each clearing account, you'll need to set up a separate account category in the QuickBooks Online chart of accounts for each sales channel and payment processor. For Shopify, you'll set up Shopify Payments Clearing and separate clearing accounts for each payment processor, such as PayPal, Amazon, Affirm, and others. For Amazon, set up an Amazon clearing account. For Walmart, set up a Walmart clearing account. After all sales, deposits from payment processors, and payment processing fees are recorded for the month, you'll start the reconciliation process. The first step of the reconciliation process includes reconciling sales between Shopify and QuickBooks Online. The second step of the reconciliation process includes reconciling all e-commerce clearing accounts. This is the step of the reconciliation process that I will focus on. Let's go over how to reconcile Shopify Payments clearing accounts. On the balance sheet, we can see that the balance in the Shopify Payments clearing account as of August 31st is $986.05. This represents sales made at the end of the month of August that were received in September. We'll start in Shopify by looking at the payouts made in September for sales made in August. In Shopify, we'll go to Finances and select Payouts. We'll scroll down until we see the last payout in August, and we'll open the payout for September 1st. And you'll see that all of the sales transactions were for August. You'll see the payout amount, gross sales, the fee, and the net amount paid out. Make a note of the payout amount. Next, we'll go back to the payouts and we'll open the payout for September 5th. Here we can see that all of the sales transactions were for August. We'll also make a note of this payout amount. We'll go back to the payouts and we'll open the payout for September 6th. You'll notice that we have several transactions for September, but there are two transactions for August. We'll also need to make a note of the net amount paid out for the August transactions. Here are the screenshots of the amounts that we need for our reconciliation. These are the amounts that were paid out in September for sales made in August. The total is $986.05. When we look at the balance in the Shopify Payments clearing account in QuickBooks as of August 31st, we see that the balance is $986.05 and that the total of the payouts made in September for August sales was for the same amount of $986.05. Since the amounts agree, that means that the clearing account is reconciled. let's take a look at how you reconcile clearing accounts for other payment processors. In this example, I will show you how to reconcile the Stripe clearing account. Keep in mind that every payment processor is different and that the reports and information that you will need for each payment processor will vary. Go to Stripe and select Reports and Payout Reconciliation. Select the appropriate date. In this case, I will use the month-to-date report to view payouts for sales made in the prior month. Scroll down to download the payout reconciliation. Open the downloaded spreadsheet and look for the sales made in the prior month. You'll see the date under the created column, and you'll see the amount under the net column. The balance in the Stripe clearing account as of September 30th is $266.72. And the amount paid out by Stripe on October 1st is also $266.72. And that means that the Stripe clearing account is reconciled. Here's a question I'm often asked about clearing accounts. Should balances in the clearing account zero out each month? E-commerce clearing account balances will not zero out every month because of the timing differences between when sales are made and when payouts are received. That's why it's important to reconcile the clearing accounts every month for each payment processor. Let me know in the comments if you have a different process for reconciling e-commerce clearing accounts. I'd love to hear from you. For resources on Shopify bookkeeping and financial management, check out my free Shopify bookkeeping blueprint. I've linked that for you in the description. Are you ready to work with a trusted and reliable team of Shopify bookkeeping pros who understand how to reconcile e-commerce clearing accounts? Then check the description below to learn more about Mavency and whether we'd be a good fit for working together. Thanks for joining me today. Remember to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell to stay updated with all things e-commerce bookkeeping. Till next time, happy selling!